Hey everybody, welcome back to Spyro Year of the Dragon. In this video, we're going to head to Molten Crater. And I want to note before we start this level, from this video on, we're recording using the Greatest Hits version of the game on disc. Previously, I was using the download version on PSN, which is based on the original release. There are actually quite a few differences, but from now on, we're using the Greatest Hits version.
And there's a skill point in this level, but you need Sergeant Bird to get it, which...
Oh, yeah, and we actually can't even complete this level in the first place. Fully completed. So, let's hit in. Yeah, we're going to do as much as we can before we require Sergeant Bird. And when do you get him again? It's World 2, right?
Yeah, the next world. Home world.
Oh, okay, so immediately after we do the boss, okay.
Yeah.
Rhinox are running rampant around here, but I can't get anyone out of the Tiki Lodge long enough to do anything about it.
Okay, these are like the main people here. They're like the Tiki men.
Yeah, I don't know if, well, maybe it's just me, but like, it kind of reminds me of Idle Springs, because in that level, in Ripto's Rage, all the enemies were like the Tiki guys.
Oh yeah, oh, I didn't even see this dude here. this we need a key for. We get that later on in the level. Oh. There's like a crack in the wall.
Yeah.
That's another skill point here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, there's two. There's that one that you can do as Spyro, and then the other one you need to do as Sergeant Bird. So we'll have to come back.
Yeah, that's not a big deal though.
Right? Yeah. This level isn't very long. I thought he hit you, actually.
Yeah, I thought he did too. Like, they see you from, like, farther away. Uh-huh. Oh, there's no point to flaming those flowers, by the way. They're just there.
Yeah.
It's like, eh. Oh, well.
I would have thought that would be a skill point in one of the levels. They, like, appear in some of the levels, but I think here is where they show up the most.
Right. That was Indiana Jones dude. Oh, he fell off right off the cliff.
Ooh. Oh, he fell in the lava.
Yeah, he did.
He burned his butt.
Alright, here's the first dragon egg here, Ricky. Ricky?
Just Ricky. Like, Ricky Lake.
Oh, jeez. And she's scratching herself like a little dog. I think, yeah, there's something here. There's a fodder here, like these slug creatures.
Slugma. Yeah. Wow, look at his eyes. They're going crazy.
One of them's looking at on the left, one's looking at the right. Oh boy. Alright, we have Zoe here.
Be sure to keep your friend Sparks the Dragonfly healthy, Spyro. If his health is low, torch a little creature like the slug below me to release a butterfly.
Yeah, thanks. We literally just talked about that.
Yeah. Also, that slug was looking up her skirt.
Oh my god.
Perverted slug. Oh. Some of the enemies make really funny noises.
Yeah.
I think the... Oh, man, what was that level? Cloud Spires? Well, actually, they hit you. They, like, do that stupid laugh.
Yeah.
Does she talk to you? Okay, good. I was like, I'm not ready for this. Okay, this main area here, you're actually going to have to float over to that rock, like, part on the rock. There's some gems here.
Yeah, there's quite a few like little spots like that.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them are trickier than others.
Yeah.
He was like inspecting his whip. It's like, yep. Whip this, it real good.
Yeah, this is 100% whip right here.
Watch out.
I saw him coming out of the corner of my eye. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, I see you there. I see what you're doing. Alright, got a few more here. There's actually another one across from here. Actually, there's...
One around the corner.
Yep.
With the guy on there. Actually, I think that's also where the key is for the treasure chest in the beginning. Oh. And like, if you saw those bars right there, after you talk to the guy at the end and he opens the portal, the bars go down and you can go back to the beginning where the treasure chest is.
Okay.
I think that's like faster than going all the way
back. Yeah, it definitely is. Oh shoot.
Oh.
I pushed the wrong button. It kind of scared me a little bit. There it is. Burn that flower.
So, do you think it's interesting that like some of the stuff in the original Spyro game, they like skipped for Ripto's Rage, but it's back in this game.
Oh, yeah, it is.
I mean, Dragon Egg Zorn is prevalent in the original one, but there were 12, I think. And now they're back as like the main collectible.
Mm-hmm.
And then you also have the Egg Thieves again.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know how many treasure chests with keys there are, but there were a few of them.
Yeah, that's right. Game. I didn't think about that. They weren't in Ripto's Rage at all, right?
No.
I don't remember them.
Here, take this egg. They were giving them away at the Tiki Lodge last night.
Oh, looks like Curly's a little sick.
Achoo!
Yeah. Oh, come the troops. And here's the Sergeant Bird part right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. You probably guess how we have to free him again.
Money bags.
Yeah.
Which is right over there.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Let me grab these couple gems here.
Spyro! You're just in time. I saw two egg thieves run through this door. Well, actually, they paid me to guard their hideout, but that's irrelevant. I'll happily let you through the gate to chase them down for a small finder's fee. Thank you, Spyro, and best of luck catching those dastardly egg thieves.
Okay, I'm gonna go back to the beginning so I can get... there's a couple gems here. And then the chest. No enemies, right?
No, they're still gone.
Just wanna make sure there's not like a boar out of the corner and they get... Here we go. Quite a few of them in that.
Yep.
Alright, let's see what we got so far. I think we don't have that many eggs, and as... Heads. How many of these are ones you get as Sergeant Bird?
I think two of them.
Okay. We don't even have half the gems yet, but there are gems that you get as Sergeant Bird as well.
I think there's actually a lot in there.
Oh, the Sergeant Bird part?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I mean, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, I don't know.
There's like a... Oh, there's
oh,
a
Oh, shoot, I forgot about that, yeah.
Nice. But I think there's like a lot of like ones that are the yellow gems in his area, so like a lot of tens and quite a few fives and stuff, so it's like the higher number gems are in there.
So since they're the higher number, they're probably not as like not a huge amount, but you know, they're worth a lot.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Alright, well, I think that's it. That I always forget about that little part down there, so
yeah.
Might as well go through here. What's through here? Oh, this part. Okay. Yeah. This is actually kind of fun.
Are you the dragon looking for all those eggs? Because I saw a shifty-looking character with one over there.
Yeah, of course he's talking about the thief. Before I chase him, I'm just going to grab all these. Is that what you... Oh. How about this right here? Those ones kind of throw me off because you're like when you come out of the portal, you're like, oh, let's talk to him, but
it's like
out of
view.
Exactly.
Line of sight.
Do you usually go after the thief first or just collect everything?
No, I just go for like the gems. Because, I mean, I get the ones that are like down here on the ground first, and then there's more up on like that ramp that he's on.
There's a skill point.
Yeah.
All it is just hitting that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's not difficult, but it's just something that you might be like, oh.
Not think about. Yeah. Plus, I mean, in the part before this, like the main, I guess, part of this level, there were all those cracks in the wall that didn't do anything.
Right.
So
true.
You might just be like, oh, more decorative cracks in the wall.
Oh. Actually, we can open this now, right? Or no, that's
not
active.
Yet.
I forgot. Yeah. But you just need to run into it with the supercharge.
Uh-huh.
Let's see. There's quite a few, like, scattered around.
Yeah.
I think that was it, though. That should have been it. I'm gonna...
give another...
What was that? Do you see that sparkly thing?
No.
Okay. Maybe it was just, like, lag or something from collecting the gem, but...
Yeah.
It looked like the...
It could have been, like, the number bouncing. When you pick it up, it has, like, a number that...
Oh, yeah, okay.
...tells you how much it was.
That probably was it, then. Yeah.
Sometimes that throws me off.
One thing I definitely noticed about the... Well, we'll talk more about the differences maybe as the videos go along, but one thing is the original release or the PSN version that it's based on, or that's, you know, the same version, there's a lot of lag in the levels.
Yeah.
If you notice that in the videos, and you definitely don't, there's no lag in this at all whatsoever, at least from what I've seen.
No.
But if you notice that in the videos, that wasn't like YouTube or anything, or like...
That was the game.
Yeah, that was the actual game. I mean, it didn't make it unplayable, because there's some games where it just lags like crazy. It's hard to play, but, you know, the frame rate dropped and it was noticeable.
Yeah.
Oh, I missed that. This one... It helps to, like, stay close to the walls here.
Yeah.
Shaves off a little bit of time.
Got him. Nice.
Alright, that's Thief 1 of 2, and we got Moira.
That's a weird name. I wonder how they came up with the names for some of these.
Hey, there goes another one! He was really fast. Maybe if I activate the supercharge, you'll be able to catch him.
Alright, this thief is in red, and we have to use the supercharge. But first, let's open this. Oh, there. Actually, wasn't sure where it was over that hill. Okay. Let's see if I can do this. I mean, it's more or less the same, except...
fast.
Yeah, it's just a lot faster. Got him.
Wow.
My controller's going crazy. I need to turn that off, because it...
The vibrate?
Yeah.
Kermit.
Kermit the dragon here.
Oh, Kermit.
That was my god-awful Kermit impression. Actually, let me turn that off now. It's really annoying. Like, as you're running, it's like, I don't need to have that.
Vibration off.
There we go. Plus, it'll probably come out in the... through the mic anyway.
True. Did you get that purple gem that came out of that...
The jar?
I
can't remember. I'm gonna double check. I might have, but... I can't remember,
though.
I
think it's right past there. Oh, no.
I know. Broke the jar, but not...
Yeah.
That's weird.
I wasn't sure, like...
That's pretty weird, because usually it goes hand in hand, like you do both, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hey! You grabbed your horns up my butt.
Hey. Take me out to dinner first.
Wait, is that it?
I think so. Everything else is in Sergeant Bird's.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I could do another sweep real quick, but I'm pretty sure I grabbed all the gems.
Yeah.
Actually, while we're doing this, and talk more about the differences between the versions. Another, actually a really big difference is the music is completely different in certain parts. Like, actually, one of the like really obvious ones is the final boss fight uses the Sunrise Spring Home theme.
Yeah, it doesn't match at all.
Instead of her own
theme.
Really
weird.
Yeah, exactly. I read that some of the boss themes are kind of mixed up too.
Oh, really?
Or like, they reuse boss themes. From what I read, I don't know if this is true or not, but it would make sense that the game was kind of like, not rushed, like the game was complete, but it's just like there were some oversights.
Oh, okay.
So, you know. Oh, and there's also a cutscene missing from the original release. You could still view it after you beat the game with like a cheat code, but it like doesn't play in the normal game. It just skips completely. I'm pretty sure I got everything.
Yeah. Everything else must be in the Sergeant Bird area.
Yep. And with that, let's get out of here. Actually, we're just right near the exit portal. And there we go. But yeah, I mean, if you get the PSN version or the original disc release, like the non-greatest hits version on the original PlayStation release, I mean, it's still playable. It's still, you know, a great game. You're only missing out on, like, a few things.
Wasn't there also the glitch at one of the speedways where, like, you were unable to get an egg?
Yeah.
If you didn't
get it
the first time around?
If I remember right, that's corrected in this version.
Yeah.
And there's also a glitch, I think it was in Fireworks Factory, where there was, like, there was something missing. Like, there was a glitch that could happen. Like, you're missing, like, a gem or an egg. Something like that. I only read about it a little bit. We'll get to that later. But, yeah, I mean, it's still a playable game. Like you said, there might be some glitches, but it's still playable. Yeah. I would hate to get far into the game and not be able to get...
Yeah.
Was it 117 is the highest percentage?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. All right, but that's pretty much it for this video. Like we said, we have to come back to... Oh god, what was that level?
Molten Crater?
Molten Crater. I keep wanting to call it Magma Cone, but that was in that Crypto's was in Rage.
The little fawn guys.
Yeah. With the horns and stuff like that. But, yeah, we'll get back to that after we unlock Sergeant Bird in World 2. And then in the next video, we're going to head here, which is... Oh, I didn't mean to talk to him, but oh well. Seashell Shore. That's going to be a pretty crazy level.
Can you say the name of that level 5 times 5?
No, I cannot. I'm not even going to try. It's not going to happen.
Seashell Shore.
Yeah, you messed up already.
Stop, it's a tongue twister.
Yeah, I mean, that's why they picked that level name. It's like, that's a tongue twister. Let's use that.
Seashell Shore full of seals. Yeah.
Alright, but that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.
Bye!